Let us now evaluate the arrival times of various signals in this. Okay, I'm going to just evaluate the arrival times of various signals now. Fine. So let's assume the following: TGP equals 1, T sum equals 1, T carry equals 1, T mux equals T bypass equals 1. Everything is unit delay. Okay. So how long does it take for the signal to arrive at this point? Out here. Remember A and B. A 0 to 15, B 0 to 15 arrive at time 0. Right? So this arrival time is 0. How long does it take to generate GP? 1. Right? 1. Okay? Now what about for the arrival time at this point? Yeah? No, think carefully. Look at this expression here. You have to ripple through that, right? The first stage you have to ripple, you have no choice. What is that there for? Yeah. So it will take 4 units of time for the signal to propagate through that, but the signals arrived at 1. Therefore, this has to be 4. Ah, sorry, 5. You're right. 5. What about in the other cases? Bits 4 to 15. Arrival time at the output of carry 0, carry 1 block. Yeah? Same thing. Right? It's all parallel. It has no connection to carry in yet. 5. What about output of the multiplexer now? Huh? 1 unit. So, arrival time here is 6. Arrival time at the next stage is here 8. Right? You are going to look at max of 6 and 5 plus 1, 7. Max of 7 and 5 plus 1, 8. Max of 8 and 5 plus 1, whatever. You can keep going like that. What is the obvious problem in this case? Is it the delay of mux? Is it the delay of mux? So what happens if I take this to 128 bits? And the last stage, let's say it's 4 bits, right? It's a 4-bit segment that I've made. The last stage would have generated this carry out, carry 0, carry 1 block would have been ready in 5 units of time. But for the carry to arrive, it's going to take forever. You can see that this gap, 6, 5, 7, 5, 8, 5 is growing linearly. It's going to go 9, 5, 10, 5 and it'll keep going. So that is it's just a waste of time. There is signal which is ready to evaluate, but it is just waiting. How do I overcome this problem? I'll give you a clue. This is called a linear carry select adder. What is it that I have to change? Sorry? So what is it that is actually causing this mismatch in delay? Suppose I made the segment 3 bits. What would be this delay here? What would be the delay here? 4. What would be the delay here? 5. Exactly. See, the first stage is the one through which you have to ripple. So if you reduce that ripple time, then the output will be ready quickly. But now the following stages actually have more time to evaluate other things and be ready. In some sense, if you want a circuit to be very fast, you have to make sure that all signals to its input arrive at the same time. There's no point in making something wait. In fact, earlier also in the gate sizing algorithm that I told you, in a full circuit, what happens is when I have multiple paths and all of them, let's say, have around similar delays, post optimization, you will find that all these delays become even closer. All paths, basically, you're saying that, okay, I don't want one path to be very fast. So I'm going to make that, little slower, thereby making another path fast. So in some sense, this similar delays is what optimizes the performance of a circuit in general. And that's exactly what we are doing here. Make sure the arrival time at the input to every block is similar. Don't waste time waiting. Okay, so what do we do? Basically, you just have to do the following. Like he said, instead of having uniform bits in each segment, have increasing bits. Obviously, you have to start with the least number, which is 2 bits. Right? You have a 2-bit ripple adder, in which case the arrival time at after compute GP will obviously be 1. Right? There's no doubt in that. At this, it will be 3. Because I have to ripple out through only 2 stages now. 2 plus 1. This will be, because that is now rippling through 3 stages, it's going to take 4 units of time. So this will be 4, 5, 6, right? 7 and so on. Now the multiplexer will take 1 unit of time. So this will arrive at 4. What have we done? We have made sure these 2 arrival times are the same. Earlier, that used to happen at 5. Now it is happening at 4. Now at following stage, again, arrival time is 5. The arrival time of the other stage is also 5. Everything we are matching perfectly like this. Correct? So now how do you find out, how to partition this? Let's say you start with M bits. Right, let this be M bits. Progressively, you increase it by 1. This is M plus 1, M plus 2, and so on. So, if I have a total of N bits, clearly, this is going to be M plus 1 plus M plus 2 up to, let's say, M plus P. Okay? Or M plus P, yeah. So what is the sum? Sorry? M into P plus 1 plus P into P plus 1 by 2. Right? If M is very, very small, right? So let me write this as P plus 1 into M plus P by 2. Assume that I need a 128-bit adder. Right, then you can neglect this M, right? I can say N is approximately P squared by 2. Of course, P and P plus 1 also I am approximating as P, which implies that P is equal to root 2 N. That's the number of stages. Right? So, how many bypasses do I have to do? P bypasses I have to do, or P plus 1 bypasses I have to do, right? Therefore, I think I should have made this P minus 1, M plus P minus 1 actually, you know, so that, let me do that, because it makes the P into P minus 1 by 2. Okay, yeah, then what happens is there are P stages, right? Then I can now write the T, I'll fill out that because the name is in, we will get the name from this expression. T GP plus how many ripples? M T carry plus how many stages of bypasses now? P stages of bypass. Plus T sum. What is P now? This is approximately root of 2n. And therefore, this is called a square root adder. Okay, this is a, that was a linear carry select adder. Square root select adder. Carry select adder. Clear? Any questions here? So, what we have done is, if you look at this whole, you know, so by the way, what is shown here is just an other time representation of what happens for signal flow. Okay, let me just show you that. So, because if you see the slides, so if you look at the linear carry select chain, right, on the y-axis is time, t equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? This is my carry zero stage, right? So, in one unit of time, the GP signals would have been ready. What is shown on this black and red is the rippling through the four bits there in that stage. So, in one unit of time, the signal goes by four units of time, right? What you see is across all the stages, right? Maybe I'll just explain this there. This is also another nice way of visualizing this delay, right? We wrote out the arrival times, but this is another nice way of visualizing the delay. So, what is this? Yeah.
Yeah. So what is shown here is essentially the carry is rippling through the stages here. So this delay is basically the delay through this ripple adder. But the point is, all the ripples happen in parallel. That's why you see every stage is rippling in parallel. So this is a nice way to visualize and see that it's all a parallel operation, right? Now you got to go through the bypass mux. This is the bypass, T bypass, right? This delay is basically the MT carry. And of course, this delay is the TGP. So now what you see is the carry has arrived here. My rippling has finished at T equal to 4. You have to wait that 1 unit of time for this carry to be available. Only then the evaluation can happen. From here, it will take 1 unit of time now. So what you see is, even though all the stages have their rippling done by T equal to 4, you are still waiting longer and longer as you progressively go into the higher bits. Longer and longer is, this is the waiting time. Right? Sorry. This is the waiting time. Here, you are waiting 2 units of time. And here, you are going to wait 3 units of time. Okay. Now, when you go to the square root adder, what you see is, now the rippling time itself is different for all the stages. The first stage ripples in 2 units of time, right? This thing. Second stage ripples in 3, third in 4, 4 in 5, and so on, right? And therefore, the waiting time is basically 0. Essentially, we have eliminated the waiting time. So, this is another nice way to represent the delays, right? And so, if you see my slides, you shouldn't get confused as to what this representation is. Okay?